We've talked about recording and streaming, but what if you want to do both at the same time? This is actually pretty common to have a local copy for highlights, or if you just want to upload a higher quality copy of your stream VOD once the stream is over. Let's take a look at how to set it up. Any high-tier live production needs a variety of scenes to show and quick, precise switching between them. The Elgato Stream Deck gives you 15 keys with customizable LCD screens behind each one that can execute macros, application launchers, and do scene switching and source muting for OBS, and you can nest folders for more actions and unlimited power! Grab yours today via the link in the video description. I'm EvilsVox here to make tech easier and more fun, and welcome back to my OBS Studio tutorial course. I have many, many more videos on the software linked in the playlist in the video description. Check that before asking questions and check the introduction video to learn how this course works, just in case you get lost. OBS Studio has a separate Start Streaming and Start Recording buttons, which allow you to control recording and streaming separately. But you're able to do both at the same time. Even better, you have the option to record either the same quality copy as your live stream or record a much higher quality local copy. This is a pretty powerful feature, and it may require powerful computer hardware to make work. To set this up, all you really have to do is make sure your output mode is set to advanced in your profile and customize your recording and streaming settings separately. For example, I stream to Twitch using X264 at around 6 megabits per second, but record locally using NVIDIA Invinc at 30 megabits per second. Get your settings set appropriately, hit apply, and then make sure you hit start recording alongside start streaming. If you're looking to edit your VODs or highlights after you stream, you can also utilize multiple audio tracks with your recording. I have videos on how to set up your streaming and recording profiles, as well as how to best utilize multiple audio tracks in the course playlist. If you're like me and tend to forget to hit start recording at the right time after you've started streaming, there is a handy fix. In general settings, you can check the automatically record when streaming button so that it presses the button for you. Also, you can check keep recording when the stream stops if you have an issue with needing to start and stop streaming or your internet cuts out or something like that. I leave the second one unchecked, but I tend to utilize the automatically record option just to save my bacon. As we discussed in the bitrates video, you'll want to be careful when choosing your recording bitrate to consider how long you plan on streaming. My overkill 250 megabit per second recording bitrate is great for short recording bursts for my videos, but would quickly fill up all of my available storage for my long 6-hour Twitch streams. So for streaming, I've lowered the recording bitrate to 30 megabits per second. For more information on bitrates, check the bitrate considerations video in the course playlist. And that's all it really takes. You can record and stream at the same time and in different qualities. If you have the ability to utilize hardware encoding from NVIDIA or AMD, it's generally better to use that capability for recording locally and X264 for the live stream. The X264 codec looks better at low bit rates, whereas Invinc or AMD VCE tends to look better at higher bit rates. I hope this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course has been helpful for you. If it was, Falcon Punch, that like button, get subscribed for awesome tech videos. If you like game streaming, come follow me on Twitch and leave me a message in chat. Until next time, I'm EvilsVox. Happy streaming.
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full master class are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more. Also, consider joining us on Patreon to help keep tech education free. Go to patreon.com/EvilsVox to sign up.